Do I remember what we're doing? Nein. Ach, we are here.
I feel like Alyssa and I should be better friends.
That hurt.
Damn, I better rewind.
Well, I guess we have to redo this.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
Can't believe we have to redo this, but whatever. Let me know if the music's too loud.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
Glad to see our campus is eco-friendly.
Cool. It's just my ears that are dying. Make art, not war. Then why did you glitter? Stop it! Stop it!
Alyssa, move your...
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Literally accidentally hit the button and it wouldn't stop. I'm just like... Ah! Whatever.
I always get a little giddy when I think about having my own room here.
No, stop it. Alright, what did we decide to do?
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Right, we decided to intervene. Even though we could have taken a picture and then intervened.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse
us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
I will remember.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a
Max,
lot.
You're my superhero!
I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me.
Officer...
Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business?
Officer David Dickhead. Life is Rampa. Here's a good question for you. So... You know, macaroni and cheese, yeah?
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
What else would macaroni and cheese be?
I don't have a car. Yet. Who toilet papers a bike?
No, I'm getting there. I'm establishing something.
The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster. Now this really pisses me off. So entitled. Sorry, handicapped folks. My truck needs these two spots more than you do.
So you know how it's called mac and cheese? Is it called mac and cheese because we're too lazy to say macaroni and cheese? Or is it actually called Mac because it's an abbreviation for mac and cheese? Macaroni and cheese. So is it Mac and cheese because we're lazy?
If I get too close.
Or are we just repeating the. Or are we just repeating it?
That layer of dust is begging for my finger.
You know,
it's
like.
Not a dirty window
rip in peace.
Somebody writes clean me on it.
Mac and cheese, rip in peace. I'm so dirty!
I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay lots.
So which is it? Focal point achievement unlocked. Panda's very interested in your choice, by the way. Her opinion is...
The whole town is turning into one giant missing person's
mac poster. And cheese, and mac is just short for macaroni. I am just playing devil's advocate and saying both options are
Max,
true.
Get your ass over here.
It's a bird!
I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that.
Can't read that. It says tarred... Squiggly? Oh, I see.
I don't get it. How could Zack and Victoria do that to me?
Juliet still looks upset about Zack and Victoria. I don't blame her. Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max.
Yeah, it's a squiggly.
Sorry. I'm still screwed up.
Yeah, we know.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zack yet?
I don't remember what happened.
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
I'm not gonna say it out loud. But, they got rid of the serve and put the tard there. So it's not reserved anymore, it's...
Come on over here, please.
You know, wanna know what song stuck in my head? See? Aw, fuck. It says look, not check. Don't worry, I'm not gonna say it out loud. I'm not that dumb. I thought it said check. Check yes, Juliet. Because that song is now stuck in my head. And now it's stuck in yours.
Max,
you're welcome.
Get your ass over here.
Shut the fuck up. I'm busy.
Look at Warren and his Wayback Machine. He's a brave man. And there's Warren. Did he actually buy a used car?
What's the problem with buying a used car? All of my cars have been used.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem.
He went for a hug.
New wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There was one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
Panda's crying.
It's been a strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Yeah, she wants to watch this.
Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw.
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
That
so,
might not suck.
Did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Movie booty?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
Apropos.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Pirate connoisseur.
Ha, ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it?
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
No.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds
so
awful
you're
the way
sensitive.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Babes with boobs.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new, I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Headbutt!
Hey, leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore Wait, in the no. bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody messes with me! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beatdown for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I wanted to. I was just so tripped out over leaving Arcadia.
Oh, please. I'm sure your phone and laptop were frozen in time.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Broken? Oh, man, are you serial?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Are you serial?
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
He actually is a tiny tool. I guess they're the kinds of friends that can, you know, insult each other and not, you know, feel bad about it. I'd be like... I just feel like shit if my friend said all that shit to me. I'd just, you know...
Come on in. Don't be shy. The house still looks nice. Home, shit, home.
It's not a father-in-law, it's a tool-in-law. Get it? Of course, I'm not saying it was wrong. Also, tits on display. But, like, I'd still feel like absolute shit. But also, I understand the whole, you know, you just moved.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
But, yeah.
It's cool. At least we can chill out. This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
You're sick.
Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair. Chloe's dad built this dresser. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her.
Suck it! Fuck
Chloe
all.
Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
Dad is gone. That's sad.
Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
She's got some oregano.
Hard to believe Chloe was my BFF just 5 years ago.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
I don't feel grown-up, just more confused as I get older. Especially after today.
Gee, thanks. I was hoping to hear something positive.
About me?
No, about me. Duh. I thought you'd at least be happy taking photos. Forget it.
Wait. What did I undo?
Totally changed.
I undid something.
Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
Fuck. Giving the wrong shit, and it's like undoing things I saw. I know that if I'm like don't look at something.
Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret club.
So tell me, what?
I take photos of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely, not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless.
Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
So, who is she? Do you mind talking about her?
Rachel Amber. She was my... angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
Oof. I don't like either of these options.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
She's hangry. Alright, I'll take that into consideration.
Chloe's trash overfloweth. Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
I love how we just can be a snoop and nobody gives a fuck.
So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. Is this a desk or a storage space? Too bad I can't stream any music from Chloe's laptop. She looks super happy. She looks super sad.
Super happy, super sad.
She looks super stoned. It won't play without any power. Hey, that TV used to be in the living room. I wonder what Chloe keeps in here.
Pictures. I wonder what she keeps in here. Pictures.
Look at that.
Oh.
Chloe and her dad were so close.
Me and Daddy. Everybody lies.
I'm not into them. Too pretentious.
That's a pretentious thing to say. Oregon coast.
This postcard is from Rachel Ember.
Miss you. Okay.
Man, I remember this furniture. We spent all day painting it blue. Chloe loved that blue. We had such a blast drawing these together.
She's a killer. Power girls. Yeah. Yeet. Alright, anything else? No, a bag.
This looks like a laundry bag.
You look
and
like a laundry bag.
Like dirty laundry. Gross. Old cardboard boxes.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks. Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Let's break it a couple times.
There's the power strip. Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Blaze.
Goodbye.
Whoa, dark. I cannot see anything. I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me.
Well, it sounds like a crown.
I wonder if Chloe is taking those pills. I hope she's okay.
Oh darn, it's not an accurate scale. That or we weigh nothing.
This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products. You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am. This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today. Uh-oh. The prices are late on their bills.
The bird that just smashed.
Joyce looks happy. Chloe's stepdad might not be a douchebag after all.
Can you not see who this douchebag-in-law is? God, you're slow.
Joyce still works at the diner, and Chloe's new dad is a security guard. Uh-oh.
I love how she hasn't put two and two together yet.
Oh my. Chloe made this for Joyce on Mother's Day years ago.
But did you seriously not see the bird fly into the window?
Oh shit! Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it.
It caught me off guard, that's why. I was just like, pfft. Good bird.
Dog tags, sweet. David Mattson.
And she's still not put two and three together yet.
Act, React, or Die, a 21st century survival guide. Whoa, apocalypse self-help.
So if we close the window like this, then the birds stay trapped in here.
You've been resurrected, birdie.
Fly,
be free. Aww. Joyce has a little shrine to William. Her new husband may not be such a douche.
No, he is.
Joyce always loved her mail order catalogs of useless crap.
Alright.
Oh my. Chloe made this for Joyce on Mother's Day years ago.
Now we're gonna have to rewatch everything.
I see why she would keep it.
Reread everything.
Joyce still works at the diner. And Chloe's new dad is a security guard. Uh-oh.
So how many people are gonna get mad at me for laughing at the burby?
Uh-oh. The burb. The prices are late on their bills.
Smashing into the window.
Joyce looks happy. Chloe's stepdad might not be a douchebag after all. Uh-oh.
Okay.
The prices are late on their bills.
Pfft.
These books have not been touched since the last decade. Nothing's changed. Except for me and Chloe.
And like everybody else. I love how you can still hear the burp.
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days.
It's the Madsons. Gosh.
Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore.
T-T-Y-L.
I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever.
Squeaksnax. Would you like some Squeaksnax? It makes your nose grow. What journal?
Joy still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon.
Oh, I can.
I'd love to go to Paris, too. At this rate, they'll be lucky to get to Portland. Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking. Brr. I can feel autumn pushing out the summer. William used to grill awesome burgers for us.
Why would you store your...
I wonder if he was the last one to use this.
Why would you store your ketchup and mustard outside?
We made this grave for Chloe's kitty.
Aww.
Poor Bongo. He never saw that car coming.
He never saw that car.
That took Chloe and me the whole day to draw. It's almost invisible now. Oh, I loved this swing. William made it just for me and Chloe.
Bongo was a cat, not a dog.
Hey, I remember that stain. Chloe and I knocked over Joyce's wine bottle and we scrubbed forever, but it never came out. We got so busted. If I took this picture, the deer would be standing on your ass. Damn, it's the couch. We used to pretend it was a pirate ship.
Yeah, I don't know either.
Looks like a shipwreck now.
Well, that's the garage. Wait, are there two doors to the garage?
I guess they're aging, these books.
It ages like a fine wine. Damn, it's the couch. We used to play pirates on it.
Nope. Someone locked it from the other side. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Nothing. This is so lame. Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years. Cool, now it's opened. Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead.
Must be a gearhead.
Poor little deer. It's not enough to kill you, they have to display your head. I wonder what's in those files up there. Shit! Butterfingers!
Kate Marsh. Why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally weird. I don't want to look at these creepy photos again. Why does David have them? No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
Not David.
This must belong to Chloe's stepdad. Should I switch the song? Decisions, decisions. Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why.
Placement of cameras.
What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
Yeah, that is super creepy. Oh, not in Chloe's room?
Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. Yes! Score! Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. That does not look stable. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Yes, you have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
I don't think there's anything else I can't. I think I've examined everything.
I love that they have the same old answering machine. And there's a message.
Chloe, if you're listening, Pete was cruising home off duty and told me he saw you near that garbage dump. Now I've ordered... told you to stay away from that place. It's dangerous. And you got no idea what kind of scum are living out there. Stay away. I'm serious.
Okay, well, I ordered you. I mean, I told you. I don't think there's anything else for me to look at or explore. Got everything out there. Just take the tools and leave. Right.
Hard to believe Chloe was my BFF just 5 years ago.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything else I could do, so.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
Hey,
a ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
RIP internet, by the way.
Not at all.
Still RIP internet, but...
I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Absolutely. Nathan Prescott had a fucking gun on you.
Gutless prick. That was scary. Who did you tell?
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
It's stabilized now.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max.
Lost almost 5,000 frames total, but you know, whatever.
I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it.
Right.
And now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
Shake that bony white ass.
Song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide, now!
Chloe!
I'm coming!
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing, give me a minute!
Don't get smart, just let me in.
I'm coming!
Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing, give me a minute.
Don't get smart, just let me in, now. Please.
1 second, my bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been token up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
You've been token.
Your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order. Whose is it?
Now she asked us to stay hidden. He already hates us. And she'll be happy we stay hidden, but be unhappy we did nothing. If we go out, she'll be upset, but she'll also be happy that we stepped out. We'll see both of them.
I'm sorry. That was my joint.
Well, well. I don't like strangers in my home. Especially dopers. So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do you?
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Because you're such a badass, Max, let me show you my new toy.
She stole his gun.
I'm Price. Chloe Price. Bang! Jesus, put that thing down. Chillax, sister. It's not even loaded. Yet. I thought you believed in gun control. Yes, I believe I should control the gun. It's the men who need to be checked. You trust Nathan or David? Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Just let me in, now.
One
Please.
Second.
Who's it?
Stop treating me and my mom like we're your family platoon!
Hey! Leave Joyce out of this!
I wish you'd leave Joyce! Like now!
Chloe, I'm sorry. I care about your mother and you just keep pushing me.
Oh, he doesn't care about her though.
Don't touch me again, asshole. That's the last time. Or I'll bring the cops in here so fast!
You're not that dumb.
I'd be smart to have you busted.
Chloe, someday you'll grow up.
Hey, you okay? Welcome to the real step douches of Arcadia Bay. I'm sorry. For what? He would have been a bigger dick if he caught you in here. That's hard to believe.
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can go to in this hick hole.
David was such a mean bastard to Chloe. What if I had stepped up to help?
So which option do I prefer more? Standing up to him. Or not. I know, it is for me to decide. I don't know. The real question is, which do I prefer? Which would I do if it were me? Would I stick my neck out for a friend?
If I used my power, it might help.
Or would I respect the wish of a friend to stay hidden? It's better for everybody that way. Or do I just go with the game and what I think the game is telling me what to do? I don't fucking know. Obviously.
Damn, what are you waiting for? Open the window.
Damn it, I didn't go far enough. God damn it, I hate it when that happens. It's like, you reach right at that point and it's just like, nah, fam. You weren't there.
Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing, give me a minute.
Don't get smart, just let me in, now. Please.
1 second, my claw is stuck.
Okay, I'll hide.
Chloe, open this door.
I'm hiding.
I'm giving you exactly 3 seconds to... What?
I'm sorry. Cut.
Down.
Now I'm doubting this one. Do I ever have a final answer? Let's be honest. Stop it!
Chloe?
I'm coming!
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm...
Just let me in. Whose is it?
No more options.